In this series of tutorials, we are learning AutoCAD 3D from start to finish. In the previous tutorial, we have learned about revolve command in detail. Now, in this tutorial, we will solve this exercise based on what we learned in previous tutorials. If you want to learn AutoCAD 3D from very basic level, then link to that playlist is given in description. Please watch this complete tutorial to understand revolve concept perfectly. To receive new video notification for more such type of videos, please subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. Please also like and share this video. We are making this tutorial using AutoCAD 2022, but it is also useful with other versions of AutoCAD. Let's start with this tutorial. So in this tutorial we are going to create this object, and here is the sectional view of that object. Before that, we will start new drawing. So for that, click here on this arrow. As our drawing is in metric, therefore I am selecting this ACAD ISO. If it is not available here, you can click here on browse templates, and from here you can select ACAD ISO and click on open. Then to switch to 3D modeling, click here on this gear icon and select 3D modeling. Then to show Z axis, click here on unsaved view and select SE isometric. Then to shift this UCS icon on the left side, click here on this arrow and click on this show UCS icon. I want to create this object vertical. For that, I will have to create this cross section vertical. So to make it vertical, we will click here and choose right UCS. So here this plane has become vertical. Then, as we have seen in previous tutorial, for revolve we will have to create this section portion. So we will create this section portion without this nozzle, and we will place this nozzle later on. So at first we will create this line of 30 length, then this horizontal line. Now this diameter is 30, this is 70, that is 70 minus this 30, that is 40, and divided by 2, that means this length will be 20. So click here on line, specify first point here, take your cursor below, make ortho on. Take your cursor below, ensure that you are creating your object on XY plane. Then specify height of 30, press enter, then zoom there, take your cursor on this side, 20, enter. Then this height is 70 and this total length is 140 minus this 70, that is 70 divided by 2, that means this length will be 35. That means 70 and 35. So take it below 70, enter, take it on this side, 35, enter, and enter to stop line command. Now these are separate lines, we will convert it into single object. Click on modify, click on join, select this object, press enter. So here it is now single object. Then this thickness is 8. So click here on offset, specify gap of 8, enter, select this line, take your cursor on this side and click, press enter. Then connect this portion, click on line, click on this endpoint and this endpoint, enter, then enter to repeat line command, then this endpoint and this endpoint. Click on both the endpoints, press enter to stop line command. Now these are separate objects. To connect them, again click on modify, click on join and select all these objects, press enter. Now here it is a single object. Then internal hole is of diameter 30, that means gap between this line and this center axis will be 15. That is half of this 30. So again click here on line, take your cursor to this end point, take it away. So we are tracking that point. Ensure that your object snap tracking and object snap is on. Then specify here distance of 15, enter. Ensure that ortho mode is on and click below. Press enter. Then to convert it into 3D, click here, click on revolve. Then select this profile, press enter. Then click on object, select this object. Then we want to revolve it by 360 degree. So type here 360, enter. Then to view it in 3D, click here, click on shaded with edges. Then turn this grid mode off. So here this object is created. Then next is to create these fillets of radius 5 at 3 locations. This one, and this. So for that, type F for fillet edge, then click on fillet edge, then select this edge, and orbit it. Zoom there, and this internal edge. Okay, it is not selecting that, so we will again repeat fillet command and create that fillet. Then click here on radius, specify radius of 5, enter and enter and again enter. So here this fillet is created. Then this remaining fillet, so zoom there, again F, fillet edge, then this line. Okay, it is not selecting it, so what we will do, we will just go back to 2D wireframe, press escape, click here, click on 2D wireframe. Just orbit it so that we can separate it perfectly. So here is that line. So again type F, fillet edge, select this edge. Okay, now here it is creating that fillet perfectly. Press enter and enter. Then again click here, click on shaded with edges. So here this fillet is created perfectly. Then click here, click on SE isometric. So this outside portion is created. Then next is these nozzles. Now this nozzle is located at the height of 30 from this quadrant point, and it is projected out by 10 and plus this 8. That means from this point it will be 18. That means 30 and 18. So again click here, click on 2D wireframe. And we will create it from this quadrant. Click here on line. Click on this quadrant point. Now here it is not showing quadrant. So just shift right click and select quadrant. Then click here on this quadrant. Then orbit it. Then take your cursor on this side. Specify height of 30. Enter. Take it outside. In x direction and 18, enter, press escape. So here it is created. So here are these two lines. So we will just change their colors, so those will be displayed perfectly. Click here, again here, and red, escape, close. So here it has been located. Then we will have to create circles. Then we will have to create this circle of 25 diameter. Now this circle needs to be created on this face, that means this face. So for that again we will click here, click on AC isometric. Then this face is actually front face, so click here, click on front. So here XY is aligning perfectly to that face. Then click here on circle. Then click here on this endpoint, take your cursor away, 25, enter. Here actually diameter is 25, that means radius will be 12.5. So just click, take your cursor on this blue grip, take it below, specify there 12.5, enter and escape. So here it is perfect. Then again click here, click on shaded. Then to convert this circle into 3D, click here on arrow below revolve and click on extrude. Then select this circle, enter, take your cursor inside. Now here we know that length of this red line is 18. So we will give 1 mm lesser than that is 17, enter. So that it will merge perfectly and it will not come inside. Then we want same on the opposite side, we will mirror it. For that click here on 3D mirror, select this object, enter. Then we will have to specify 3 points of plane around which we want to mirror. Or we can also mirror around this YX plane or XY plane. So click here on XY and that XY plane will be passing through this center point. So click here on this center point and delete source object. No. So here it has been created perfectly. Then next is this hole of 15 diameter. So zoom there. So before that, actually these are separate objects. So what we will do, we will merge them. For that click here on union and select all these objects, press enter. Here now it is a single object. Then we will create one circle here, click on circle, then click on the center point or end point, take it away, again radius will be 7.5, enter. Then to cut it, click here on press pull. Then take your cursor inside this circle. Once it becomes blue, click there and take it outside and click. Press escape. So here through hole is created. Then we don't want these objects. So type E, enter, select this line and this circle and this internal line. Okay, it is not selecting. Alright, press enter. Then to select that line, click here, click on 2D wireframe, type E, enter, select it, enter. Then AC isometric, click here, shade it. Then one thing remained is the chamfer. So this chamfer of 2x2 size. So for that, type CHA, click on chamfer edge, select this edge. Then click on distance, specify distance 1 as 2, enter, distance 2 as 2, enter, then enter, enter. Here the chamfer is also created. So all the details has been added. Then to change color, just double click on it and click here, again click here and choose your desired color. Press escape. So this object is ready. So that's all for now. In the next tutorial, we will learn about sweep command. And if you want to learn AutoCAD 3D from start to finish, then here is complete playlist. And please like, share and subscribe by clicking here on this icon. So thanks for watching. We will again meet in next tutorial.